We're gonna go into the best lower body lifts to help you improve throwing as a shot putter, and we're gonna start right now. Now let's think about the shot put. We're existing in a 7-foot circle. We're executing an extremely rapid movement in 7 feet. This is gonna happen in what, 1.5, two and a half seconds. All very, very fast. With that being said, if you're a glider, these lifts pertain to you. If you're a spinner, these lifts pertain to you. So you're gonna have to accelerate a 4 kilo implement or a 12 pound shot or a 6 kilo implement or a 7.26 kilo shot in a very short distance in a very short period of time so that you can throw it longer than your opponents. Now, with that being said, I'm not gonna use weightlifting exercises. I wanna use strictly lower body strength movements that you can start with that will directly impact your shot putting result. And we're gonna come in with that number 5 exercise. That number 5 exercise is going to be the single leg squat, okay? So the single leg squat, I wanna see that rear leg elevated. I wanna see good hip mobility. I wanna see good coordination and good stability. Remember, we're accelerating in a very short period of time. So we have to have good mobility. And now we've gotta start to think about strength training for shot putters. We've done a whole entire video on this in those key elements. We've gotta have good dynamic trunk control. We've gotta have good strength. We've gotta have good rate of coordination and stability. So single leg squat will help all of these factors. It's gonna help with that dynamic trunk control. And think about if we're a glider, we're coming out of the back in that unilateral position and we're gonna be more stable in the middle. Think about a spinner when they ground with that right leg in the middle, or if they're a left-handed thrower, when the left leg grounds, they're in a single leg position and they have to be able to control that position. And by doing so, and by increasing that unilateral strength, they're gonna be able to handle that speed when they ground in the middle. So use a single leg squat with that rear leg elevated. Try to touch your knee to a pad or a towel and make sure that you try to push that a little bit here and there. Every once in a while, you go for a big triple, you go for a big set of 5, something like that. You can use dumbbells, you can use a barbell, but improve your single leg squat to reap those rewards in that 7-foot circle. That fourth key lift to improve your lower body strength is a reverse hyper. Okay, now a lot of people might not have reverse hyperextension, the machine. You can also use a glute ham machine. This is another exercise that I love that can also be used in conjunction or to replace a reverse hyper if you don't have it. If you don't have that, you can use a back extension like a Roman chair. If you don't have the Roman chair, you could use good mornings. What I'm looking for is I want, with the reverse hyper, I really like how it decompresses the spine. I also like how it really lengthens all of the erector muscles along the spine. I like how it forces lengthening from the back and through the glutes all the way into the hamstrings, and it also forces your gut. You wanna focus on pushing that belly into the pad, and then as you raise your legs, your hips actually start to extend from your hamstrings, from your glutes, from even your lower back to a point. So the reverse hyper is a great exercise as an accessory. It's a great exercise for injury prevention in the lower back. And it's also just a really, really good movement that you can utilize to drastically improve the sequencing of your posterior chain. So use a reverse hyper. We use it with our throwers 2 to 3 days a week. A lot of our throwers even warm up on the reverse hyper machine because of what it does with your trunk and how it coordinates with that entire posterior chain. Coming at that number 3 spot, we've got another accessory, banded Cossack squats, okay? So a lot of throwers are extremely tight in our hips. And so when we're throwing, we've gotta be mobile in our lower back. We've gotta be mobile in hip abduction and adduction. As you go out, and if you have your foot hooked up to a band, that band's gonna pull your leg away. So you have a little bit of eccentric resistance as you're going through the eccentric movement. And then as you bring it in and you adduct the hip in, you adduct the foot into your hip, now you have to accelerate more because it's attached to a band. A lot of spinners have groin problems. A lot of gliders have groin problems. And when we learn how to abduct and adduct properly in our hips, we're increasing our mobility, we're gonna increase our ankle mobility, we're gonna increase the entire functionality of our hip girdle. So utilize these. One, you could do these as a warm-up, nice and easy. You could also use a dumbbell and have it as a goblet squat position as you do the banded Cossack squat. You can use these to warm up for throwing, anything to help you feel better all throughout that hip girdle and to really make you feel more mobile so that you can hit those monster bombs. That second key lift, and a lot of throwers love to shy away from this lift because it's hard, it's brutal. It's an exercise that everybody hates doing. That exercise is a front squat. And I love the front squat, okay? I love the front squat for the dynamic trunk control. I love it, how it forces your back to actually utilize co-contractions. I love it for the mobility that it can create in your ankles and in your lower back and even around how your knees drive forward and you have to stay very, very upright. A lot of throwers that typically will do a low bar back squat will benefit tremendously from a front squat because it'll teach them how to keep that upright posture. When they have a more upright posture, now when they ground in the middle, they're gonna be able to hold that posture a little bit more aggressively, and that's gonna help them set up for that big finish. It also carries over really well to cleans, push presses, jerks, all these other lifts that play a huge role in improving their overall power output for the shot put, even if you're a glider and for a spinner. So utilize a front squat consistently. Don't shy away from it. Work on that shoulder mobility, work on that wrist mobility. And if you can't do that, you can do zombie squats. Now, a lot of you are gonna cry when you do zombie squats because they're very, very, very challenging. I cry myself when I'm doing those zombie squats. So make sure that you're doing either a front squat, a zombie squat, even a bodybuilder's front squat to a point, and execute that consistently to help improve your overall throwing. Now, before we go into that number one lift, if you need help with a strength training program for throwing, for being a shot putter, click on the link down below, go to throwsuniversity.com, and we can help you hit monster PRs. We've had dozens of athletes go to the Division I level to compete in the NCAA. We've had 5 throwers at the Olympics this past year in Tokyo. So click on the link down below, head over to throwsuniversity.com so we can help you become a champion. Now, that number one key lift, we all saw Joe Kovacs do this. Crazy, what was it, 870 pound squat for 4. Back squat is the best lift for lower body strength training for shot putters. It is phenomenal, and there's a couple different reasons why. One, the loading, it forces you to adapt at very, very high rates, forces some trunk control, it forces crazy coordination, just overall general strength. It also improves your weightlifting movements, like technical coordination movements, like the snatch, like the clean, like behind the neck jerk, all movements that transfer tremendously well over to the shot. And then finally, I've even seen in our experience that as shot putters increase their back squat, their global strength will improve, even their bench press will improve because their back squat starts to go up so much. So they start to get a little bit more of a hormonal response from those big back squats. They start to understand how to grind and push themselves a little bit more. They understand how to recruit more effectively, and that transfers to all these other lifts. And on top of that, they also learn how to bring that intensity under the bar. And when we start to learn that in the weight room, we can transfer that over to the circle. So do back squats consistently. And I don't wanna see little quarter squats. I wanna see at least just below 90, if not ass to grass. Utilize back squats consistently. Figure out a good system to use them in conjunction with front squats and use all these other movements to improve your lower body strength training for shot put specifically. And if you need help, click on the link down below, head over to throwsuniversity.com. And until next time, guys, peace.